In this example, we're going to set up a very basic data set to illustrate how the equivalent of Vlookup works in R. So our first table over here is an employee table. So let me just hit Control Enter to set that up. And then the second table is the table with the extra information we want to look up, which includes a couple of extra columns here, base, salary, and department. So let me hit Control Enter to send that to the console and set that up too. Now, the command in R that we want to use is called left join. Now, in its very simplest form, all I need to do is basically provide these two tables. So if I provide the first table over here, employees, comma, and the second table that I want to look up over here, employees data, and hit Control Enter, right? That has done a join, and automatically picked out employee ID to connect these two on, and here are the results. Now, the way that R has automatically picked out employee ID for me is basically it's seeing that these column names are the same, and so it can use it as such. Now, if you have lots of columns in your data with exactly the same names, then what will happen is that it will automatically try and join on all of those fields. So if you want to be a little bit more explicit, what you can do is come over here and you can type in by equals employee ID. Hit tab and R will automatically complete that for you with quote marks. And I hit Control Enter and this little red message over here is going to disappear because we have specified exactly how we want R to connect our data. Now, it's worth to point out here that this command has basically joined on all of the extra columns from our second table. Now, if you were to do this in Excel, you would need a VLOOKUP with a different column number for every single column that you wanted to pull on. So in this example, we've only got two columns, but let's say you had 10 or 20, you would need to specify a column number for every single one of these columns. And if those column numbers changed because you had columns inserted or removed, deleted or moved, then those formulas would break. So not so in these examples here. Now, another thing that's quite common is, say our second table does not actually have exactly the same column name as our first table. So instead of having employee ID over here, let's say that this was instead employee number. So if I now set that up and run this example again, now this is not going to work because it can't find the column name employee ID in the second table. To set this up, what we're going to do instead is we are going to type in C, open brackets, and we're going to start to type in the column we want to look up by in the first table, so that's employee ID. Hit tab for R to complete that. And say that is going to be equal to, and I'm just going to start typing employee number and hit tab for R to complete that, and that's from the second table. Hit Control Enter, and that will work for us again. Like so. Okay. So let me just do some of these changes so that we can look at a more simple example. Now, one of the things that you will notice here is that there are some NA values. And after we've done something like a VLOOKUP, this is often something that you'd want to check for. Now, this is NAs because the data isn't available in the second table, but often what you also want to do is check the inverse to see if there's data in the second table which doesn't exist in the first table. Now, typically what you'd have to do in Excel is do VLOOKUPs on both of your tables and then do filters on both of your tables to look for things like NAs. Now, In R, what we can do, we can shortcut that by using a function called anti-join. Now, the anti-join is basically just another kind of version of the join function. So we can actually take this line here and copy this. Now, a shortcut for copying this line is I can use the Alt, Shift, and down arrow to make a copy of this line. And I'm just going to change this word left to anti. So we can see here that this has basically picked out the record with just the NAs, right? So these are the records in our first table, which don't exist in our second table. Let me make another copy of this again. So, and I'm just going to swap these around. So employee data first, and then employees. And we can see here that this is a record in our second table, which does not exist in our first table. So another thing that this can be quite useful for, let's say you have employee lists at different points in time. You could see who has who is new to the population, as well as who has left the population by using this kind of function like so. Now let's say you wanted to get only the data where there was data available in both tables. So again, this is just another variation of join. So here we're going to say copy our left join again. And this time what I'm going to do is I am going to change this word left to inner. Okay, and run that. And so these two records are the two records which are available in both of our tables. In this example, we're going to take a look at how to deal with multiple lookup items. So in here, we've got a table with just one employee record. And in the second table, we have this same employee over three different periods of time. So we have an employee with three different records. Now in Excel, if we were to look up this information and to do a VLOOKUP will only return the first record of information. Now that's sometimes the desired result, but sometimes it's not, and sometimes you want to be able to pull back all of the related employee records for that employee, which is something which is quite difficult to do in Excel. Now, in R, if we do our left join again, let's do employees and department. Department by employee ID. And send that to the console, you can see that by default, the left join will pull back all of the records for this employee. Now, again, this may or may not be what you wanted to do. What you have to keep in mind is that your first table, unlike Excel, is not necessarily a fixed size. The table started with one record, now it has three. So anytime there are duplicate records in your second table, it is going to increase the number of records in your first table. That is something to be mindful of. Now, how would we deal with this? How would we change this if we wanted to make it more equivalent to something like a VLOOKUP? Well, what we can do is we can deduplicate the results in department. And we would do that using the distinct command. So let me here type in department. And I'm going to pipe that into the word distinct. Right. And type in employee ID. So this is going to be distinct by employee ID. Now, if I just ran this right now, what would happen is I would just get that one employee ID. But what we want to do is we want to retain these other two columns as well. So to do that, I'm just going to type in here, comma, dot keep underscore all equals, and I can either type in true, or I can just write the shorthand, which is a capital T, which is for true as well. Control enter to send that to the console, and we can see that we have got the first record here, the 2011 record, where our employee is in the technology department. Now, a lot of the times, we don't really want to just pull the first record. What we really want to do is pull the latest record. So in order to do that, what we really want to do is we want to sort our results first. So to do that, what I would do is I would type in department, pipe, arrange, and I'm going to type in DSC for descending, and I'm going to type in the column name year. So if I hit control enter, we can see 2013 is now on top. So that now becomes the first record. So now we have all the components that we need. What we want to do is just kind of piece all these together. So I've got department, I've arranged it. Then effectively what I want to do is deduplicate it using this line here. To make this clear, let me just drop that to the next line. Okay, and then assign this to latest department. Right. So now if I take a look at the value of latest department, we can see we have 2013. And then what I can do is I can do our left join on employees, latest department, by equals employee ID.
This has been a lecture from my course, R Reporting and Analytics for Excel Users.